There we go. Now, hopefully everyone should be seeing a black screen. And hopefully...
It's still seeing you're dead.
The black screen should be disappearing in just a moment.
It's life for me.
Shit, look at that. This game has Dolby surround sound.
It's kind of cropped.
We only see half of the screen.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that is weird. Huh. Let's see.
Or more like a quarter. Or...
There we go.
No, still looks the same.
Yeah, it'll take a few seconds to refresh.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Now it's good.
And we are off to a brilliant start as usual. So anyway, welcome to another round of Moron Party. I am Arthur Wolf, and I am joined by Lurk, Copter, and Overfly today.
Hey.
How's it going?
Look at that, we have no files. We need to arrange for a file. See, which button does AS press? I pressed the wrong button, god damn it. You know, using a PS3 controller to emulate a GameCube controller makes for confusion. Let's see, what should we name our file, I wonder?
Egg?
Nah, let's just name it Moron for now.
Yeah. Fair idea.
Confirmed. Do not touch the memory card, you son of a bitch. Swear to God. We would like to play that save, thank you very much. Now check out these stars, what the hell. Freaking star spirits up in this bitch.
Hey, these are the guys from the first Paper Mario.
Yep. That is entirely correct, because Mario Party 5 uses a lot of references to the Paper Mario games, actually.
No wonder it's so good, then.
Dream Depot, that sounds like the name of a Chinese gas station chain.
Which one do you want to hear about? Super Dual Mode. Kalmar? You can't name a Kalmar. That's a city in Sweden, damn it. Right, let's check our options.
Why does he look so terrified?
I don't know.
I think that's a mustache.
No, it's a mouth.
Hiya out there in gaming land. His name is Kalmar, and his friends call him Kalmar. Okay. Right, not much we can do there. I was hoping to maybe preset some game settings, but screw me, I guess. Alright, let us enter the party mode.
Let's get this party started.
Prepare. And here's Eldstar. He's called Eldstar because he is old, and that is why he has a mustache. I do not want to hear the rules. Instead, take me straight to the game settings. And it's a battle royale as usual. Now, check this shit. We no longer have access to DK. DK has been removed, but in return, we have Toad.
What?
A Boo and Kid Cooper.
This is not a fair trade. At all.
These three at shit all. Stains in return for DK. Fuck that noise. Jeez. Hate this game now.
Yeah.
Let's never use them.
Okay, I suppose Boo is nice, I guess.
J. Molin is suggesting basically a bad guy setup here, so let's go with that. Why not?
Oh, good. Yeah. All for it.
There we go. Tricky to get at him. And now here's the thing. We have a lot of boards to pick from already. We have Toy Dream, Rainbow Dream, Pirate Dream, Undersea Dream, Future Dream, and Sweet Dream. Now, just a fair warning, Sweet Dream, probably one of the most harrowing game boards in the Mario Party games.
Because you shouldn't have said that, now everybody's gonna vote for Sweet Dream.
Yeah, I suppose.
Well, my vote is for Future Dream. My dream is for my vote is for Future, or can we? Are we barred from voting?
Yeah, you can vote, sure. And yes, Belgus, Dream is the new legendary. Basically, all the game boards in this one is based in part on previous ones. Pirate Dream, for example, is a complete revisit. Undersea Dream is also a complete revisit. Future Dream is also a complete revisit. Sweet Dream is a kinda sorta revisit. While Toy Dream and Rainbow Dream are the only ones that are kinda sorta new. It seems that everyone is jumping for joy at Future Dream, so let's pop in there.
Yeah.
And we'll play a standard 20-turn game, I suppose. All minigames, why not? And bonuses, hell yeah. No handicaps. They're handicapped enough as it is.
Still waiting for someone for a repeat of the infamous one rule, like star on first turn.
We can always hope. Alright, start placing your bets, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll hop into the game.
Yes, Future Dream will give you rad dreams. Yes, reader.
The Mario characters dream of electronic rats?
Probably.
Look at these guys, jeez. I wouldn't trust any of these to not cheat, seriously. Entertain your outer space curiosity in this dream. What does that even mean?
It means that the star is a is trying to sound like Carl Sagan and failing miserably.
I see. Alright.
Oh, and yes, as Alistair points out, Bad Rats is currently on sale again, so get on it. Keep circulating the codes.
Luckily, by the time this is uploaded, that will not be true anymore.
Well, you never know.
And then you'll get a YouTube comment.
And oh hey, look at that. Idiot. Where's Donkey Kong now? Well, he's over there. At the brand new DK space. And finally, we'll arrange to have 6 events in the game. The first door is way over there. So let's see how well the AI does to actually navigate to it.
My guess is badly.
Probably. Oh, instead of actually using the directional input now, you just press A to cycle. There you go. We will skip explanations. We can turn up rumble.
When are we going to place bets?
Feel free to do so now, I was about to say. Because this yep. is where it begins. I'm going to go out on a limb and bet on Boo, actually, since he's a newcomer.
Yeah, I'm leaning towards Boo myself.
I like the cut of his jib. Do ghosts actually have jibs? Not entirely sure. Oh well. And Boo just shows off exactly why we like him. And oh hey, what do we have here? This is a new item system, the capsule system. You don't pay for capsules, you just get them, but they cost a certain amount of coins to activate instead.
Yeah, that's nice, so you can trigger them when you want.
Yep.
And I bet that the AI is not going to do this effectively.
Could we get a cursed mushroom capsule? There are a lot of capsules, actually, in the game. I just want to point that out ahead of time. There are a shitload of new items in Mario 45. Other new things in the game is fully rendered 3D backgrounds and a synthesized orchestra soundtrack. This is actually the only Mario Party game that uses that soundtrack variant, because apparently the studio responsible felt that, yeah, it's not worth the time. So they skipped it in all future titles.
Modern game design, everyone.
Yeah.
Or rather, the industry.
Our first minigame is Frozen Frenzy.
I suppose if you want orchestral scores these days, you just have to put it as a stretch goal on your Kickstarter. Work for Planetary Annihilation!
So basically an entire minigame based on jumping on the heads of other players.
Okay, I suppose you're supposed to collect the crystals?
This is basically Power Stone without the
yeah.
Coin. Holy crap, Boo, what are you doing?
Yeah, this is like the famous Power Stone game mode. And I like Power Stone.
Talk about the winds of victories shifting back and forth here. Damn.
So basically, someone collects the crystals, and everyone else takes turns jumping on them. Yep, sounds like a Mario Party game.
Yep. Well, either that, or they just run into glaringly obvious hazards and wreck themselves. Now look at this. Boo is using the first capsule and placing a space effect. Now whoever ends up on that space will experience the effects.
Oh, okay, so you can actually set traps, that's nice.
Yep.
I mean, the other one could do it too, right? The one with the stickers. That would actually be rather neat, like if you could, if you place like a warp pipe, like in a few spaces above the before the star.
Oh, Kid Koopa, why? So the second item used in the game, the AI manages to land on it themselves.
Yeah, there sure is more on body.
A bone capsule.
The bone capsule is used to escape chain chomps.
Ah.
And activates automatically if you are the target of a chain chomp. Up next, Quilt for Speed. This is a Spaceballs reference.
Yeah, it took me a bit to process that. I only saw a few scenes of that movie. Unfortunately.
Yeah. Get ready for this to take a while.
Oh, God. Let me guess, the first one isn't even going to leave. Okay, it did.
Triple failure.
Oh, AI. Oh, AI roulette, how amusing you are. Looking at this actually reminds me of a game that I've been trying to play a lot as a kid, but I honestly cannot remember the name of. It was actually this game that I remember. There was actually one level that was actually set on the quilt, but it was this weird game in which you place the soldiers on a grid, then you actually had to wait until they made it all the way across, but they moved a certain way, and then the other player could actually put them in a grid. I honestly tried searching for it, and I couldn't find it. Oh, looks like Boo's ahead.
All according to Keikaku. Translator's note, Keikaku means plan.
Yeah. I actually heard about that in that on Slowpoke's podcast. About Danganronpa. That's an amusing LP, like. I literally spent an entire day reading it.
Oh jeez.
We're just so big.
Let's not start talking about Danganronpa, because then we'll be stuck here all day. Oh wow, nice work, Wario.
What?
Squared away. Let's twomp it. If any Mario Party minigame could be likened to chess, it is this one. The sheer depth of strategy in this minigame is unmatched.
Yeah. Well, this is But of course, since the AI is playing, they will naturally just run right under them.
Yep.
There goes Boo again.
Coin steal space. Why doesn't Waluigi consistently opens up and looks at his bone capsule, and then he goes, oh. And he puts it back in his pocket. You still can't use it, you know.
Well, he has a bone to pick. Who's the other contestant? So he literally booms. Wario literally booms himself up. Oh no.
No, it's a countdown, luckily. And now it's time for the chomp romp. Look at this guy.
Oh, he's so happy.
I mean, how great of a concept for a minigame is this, seriously?
Yeah, just keep making a dumb animal ram himself into walls. And Boo managed to kill himself.
I feel so bad for the poor chumps.
Are Waluigi making the identical moves or something? Seem to be pretty much in sync. Oh no, now they're...
Come on, Boo!
This game is...
Nice!
This game is horrifically cool against chain chomps. Someone call Pete on this.
Oh god, that is not a good pose. A Still looking wistfully at that bone capsule. And now he's actually discarded it. That's...
What the hell?
Huh.
What the hell is up with the AI routines for items in these games? Seriously.
He has looked at an item that is a, you know, item response item and went, well, I can't use it for 3 turns. Might as well discard it. Oh, jeez.
Why are you so terrible, Waluigi?
And we've got our second star. Nice work, fat bro. Good luck, players.
Two people at opposite ends of the alphabet. Currently in the lead. Oh! And Boo just...
Yeah, I think Boo is standing on the spot.
Yeah, so he can't actually get it right. No, and even if he did, he would be 1 coin short.
Yep.
Who got the short end of the stick on this one?
So how does a ghost triple jump anyway?
Ghost magic.
I suppose. And poor Koopa Kid, he doesn't even have legs, he has feet. How does he even?
Well, Boo technically doesn't have legs either.
Yeah, but at least he can float and flap his arms a bit. Then you have someone like Waluigi, who really should be the clear winner here, because he can just basically take big-ass steps.
But he ends up in second place.
Unsurprisingly, the weightless contestant won. Imagine that.
No way!
Oh,
who is wrecking this ship?
It's always so unfair when the star space is placed under a player. Oh, hello!
Oh, wow, and he actually won the minigame, meaning that... If it was just one star ahead, one space ahead, he would have gotten it.
Yeah.
Oh, what's this?
23 extra coins in one turn, that's not bad.
Yeah. Not bad at all.
Now I guess it comes down to who will run the lap first, and will they have enough money to buy that thing? Looks like Wario will probably reach it first, but he doesn't actually have the money.
Won't he also
yes.
trip the laser?
He will in fact land on the bomb space that he himself set, costing him all of his money. Oh, Wario. Hoisted upon thine own petard.
In this case, literally, because petards are bombs.
Yep.
I was about to say that.
This doesn't look like a very efficient way to pick fruits.
This must be hard with the perspective going on here. Cause
yeah. Yeah, it's kind of... It reminds me of that one minigame in Virtual Bart. Not sure if anyone has ever played it. For the Mega Drive.
Virtual what?
Virtual Bart. It's a Simpsons game in which Bart is actually trapped in this virtual reality machine, and it's like a series of chapters that he must complete. And there was this one mini game where you had to throw tomatoes at pretty much everyone in Springfield Elementary, where the entire difficulty ranged from the fact that you couldn't quite get the perspective right. And it was literally the most unintuitive way of aiming ever.
Oh, hello. What's this? Seems that someone is out to even out the score. Look at how happy he is. The next star is off on the northeastern platform. I don't think anyone has even visited that yet.
So you can only reach it with the teleporter?
Teleporters or in the case of Kid Koopa, perhaps a rocket.
Huh?
Let's see where he ends up. Hello, hey, look at that! He locks out. He's right there.
But he doesn't have any coins.
No, he doesn't.
But he can actually... Yeah, but he can... Well, he can actually always lap, but still... He really lucked out on that one. Unless someone throws a warp pipe at him. But I'm pretty sure this AI is not clever enough for it.
No, it seems unlikely. Wario has reached the right platform, but doesn't really help him because he doesn't have any money either. Taking turns mashing.
Well, and I thought Team Rocket's itself was hard to was extraordinarily lame. At least that one had pedals.
This is the most exciting minigame to watch.
Especially since they are about even.
Yeah.
I think the red sub is slightly ahead.
Because especially given the fact that everybody loves the water levels in Mario games, right?
Hell yeah.
And by 2 frames, Wally and the Kid Koopa win.
Also, close race.
It's like watching competitive snail racing.
That's a real sport, though.
Yep.
Actually, quite a bit of money that changes hands every year. Kid Koopa ends up with even less money. Not really helping his own cause there.
Everyone seems to be rolling so low now. It's kind of weird.
He ran out of the random numbers. He has to prove you wrong. Wario rolls a 9.
Out of spite.
He doesn't like you, Lurkopter.
I'm
betting on him.
The Flatiator.
Oh yes, no one asked, but I'm betting on Wario. Stop.
Everyone tripped on the very first mole. Jesus. And now Kid Koopa has it out for Wario, jeez.
I just love how silly Kid Koopa just looks on top of that thing.
The others are just standing there.
Oh shit, here we come. They just stand there and wave and then go, oh shit, here we come, here we come! Ah!
8 second delay really does this many favors.
Yeah, so the ghost just got flattened. That makes sense.
Not to mention that the ghost tripped.
Yeah, tripping and flattening ghosts.
The floating, massless creature.
Well, maybe it wasn't that he tripped, it was that the mole looked at him and blues are so shy.
Yeah.
It broke his concentration for a moment and made
and
him...
Who? You... I...
What?
He used a capsule with the effect of everyone exchanging capsules, but no one else has one,
no
and
one
he only had
any.
One.
Oh, boo.
You silly ghost, you. Kid Cooper got himself a mushroom. Let's see if it helps him. Waluigi seems to be having some trouble actually getting to the store, which is a shame because he has all the money he needs to buy it. Perhaps this rocket will help out.
Man, knowing the test results, it'll probably just launch him into a black hole or something.
Actually, even better, he went back to where he started this time.
Called it.
Well. Still not enough money, Wario, and you made exact same mistake as Kid Cooper and actually cost yourself money. Well... Stop! Did you know that Shy Guys drive Volkswagens?
They seem like
no.
Well, I'd like to give you a full minute to clean this up.
Well, Shy Guys are really particular about their ride.
Better shine when you're down. Okay, let's see who can get that last bit.
If they could talk, they would be constantly going wax on, wax off, wax on, wax off.
And apparently 99% was good enough. He didn't even finish.
No.
I can't help but think that the Shy Guys have basically tricked the gang into washing their cars like with some sort of like a Tom Sawyer-esque ploy. Oh, you want a fun game? Why don't you try to see who can wash our cars first?
I think that is basically how all the Mario Party games, minigames work, really.
This is just a scam to drive up local commerce.
Then again, well, these people volunteer to participate in, they probably don't really care what they're told to do. Menial labor is probably preferable to, you know, dancing on blocks above lava.
So... Or just going into the person with the wrong color gets eaten roulette.
So, Wario has enough money for a star, but will he stay on the platform? Oh, he does. Kind of disappointed there.
And then you lose 3 points.
Alright, kids, tap the tube to lose it.
Nice tube there, Wario.
He's clearly enjoying himself.
Wario is like that that one guy who's who constantly shows up to your to team sporting events showing his flashy equipment.
He operates on a different level.
Hey, check out my new golf club, guys.
But since he's crap, it doesn't help him win.
Yeah, because those people think their equipment fancy equipment will save them.
The spikes weren't aerodynamic.
That won't help you win the game.
Well, back to rolling once.
Kid Koopa draws near, but it will be enough. Luigi manages to stay on the central platform this time, at least.
I like how they keep jumping around.
It's time for a duel! And it's a star wager! One of these players will leave this duel with 2 stars. This is a dangerous bid from Wario, but can he do it? Stop! Now, a quick explanation here, basically. The blocks here are invisible, and you need to figure out your way through the maze without running into them.
Wario seems to have a head start.
Yeah, but then he actually started moving away from the goal, while Koopa Kid just walks in there. Holy shit, Wario.
Wario.
You could have taken a single step to the right and you would have won, but you started moving in the opposite direction of the goal. Oh, jeez.
Apparently when you're easy level, your AI doesn't even know basic backtracking logic.
Well, that puts Kid Koopa in the lead.
Come on, Boo, you can do this! You can still come out ahead.
Of course he can. I trust him. I believe in him. Stop! Come on, Boo, just float slightly higher. Jeez.
Is this Master Hand? Wow, for a ghost, Boo really sucks at jump rope.
Why would ghosts be good at jump rope? Seriously, though.
Well, for starters, they have no weight.
They are also immaterial.
Well, there is that, isn't it? Suppose that would be handy. You could just stand there and swing the rope.
Yeah.
It totally looks like you're doing it, but yeah. Let's see now that Koopa Kid rolls up and grabs his 3rd star. Oh, Wario. Why did you give away the star to the guy that was right in turn to grab another one?
Did Wario just say, yeah, fool? I think he probably said yoo-hoo or something.
Yeah, he usually says yahoo. But oh hey, look, it was all part of Wario's plan. He set it up so the next star is just 2 steps away from him. Question is, will he roll a 1?
Damn you, Kid Koopa.
Seriously, if Wario rolls a 1 now, then it is incredibly likely that Kid Koopa will get that star as well. That would be absolutely brilliant.
For the longest time, I actually thought Diavolo was pronounced Joel, because I actually had a video game that pronounced it like that for some reason. I have no idea why.
I actually think that in the first game, Wario was, in fact, voiced by a German guy.
Seems Wario lucked out this time. Too bad. He should have rolled a one. It would have been hilarious.
I think the best German voice actor is undoubtedly the whoever they got to voice the German dub of Dr. Eggman in Sonic Generation. Seriously, that was amazing.
That guy. Oh, hello, it's time for a coin game! Free money!
Star! Okay, this looks familiar. Pretty old school.
Old school as hell. Finish! Yeah! And everyone is super happy. Bowie's in a good striking position now. And he gets it! Been a fairly blistering display of competence so far from the AI. Apart from some, shall we say, unfortunate incidents with capsules, they've actually been really good at navigating towards the star.
Yeah, it's pretty boring.
Oh, I hate it. So dumb.
I liked it better when it sucked.
I liked it better when it sucked.
Yeah.
That does sound like the modern video game demographic. I think that Waluigi has just missed stars now twice or even thrice at this point. He has the money and he has the mobility, but he somehow always ends up being in the worst spots. Wario sets off, but he's still got some ways to go.
What does the camping capsule do?
I cannot for the life of me remember, I'm afraid.
That sounds useful.
It causes amnesia. Welp.
Boo just basically stands there.
Look at that, how happy that little asshole is.
Shit-eating grin. Kid Koopa won because everybody had a brain aneurysm at the same time.
I'm impressed they can actually run around on a rope with that much slack.
It's the magic of the Mushroom Kingdom. Or the magic of dreams.
Magic.
This is looking to be a fairly uneventful turn. Everyone just running.
Okay, so this shuffles something? Couldn't quite catch it.
Rumble fumble.
Is it set in the jungle? And now we're in the set of now we're in some sort of Nintendo version of Fantasia.
Yep. And Warriors got bit in the dick by a chain chomp.
And so did Kid Koopa.
How will he explain that to his doctor?
Well, you see, come on, Boo, you know that there's a No, don't go back to the one you just opened. Yes, thank you. Holy shit. Have you ever heard the expression, once bitten, twice shy? In this case, it's apparently thrice bitten, let's go for it again.
But Boos aren't supposed to be shy.
Have I ever told you the definition of insanity, Boo? Boo apparently doesn't know the definition of insanity.
Nice work, everyone. Nice work. I wonder who will actually reach that star first.
Quite a lot of variety of these capsules.
Yeah, there are a lot of them. Really stocking up on capsules, all of them. Oh, a chance capsule! Hello.
Oh dear. That should be pretty amusing.
He has a shitload of money, so let's just hope that the AI decides, you know what, why the hell not.
So yeah. Let me guess, while Luigi's in the Champs Capsule, all of Kid Koopa's stars go to him.
Koopa Kid stars to Boo. Make it so. If you need lasers, and if you can find them, you can always hire the Beam Team. Stop. Well. Yeah. Not really much to discuss there, was there?
Oh, damn it, Boo!
Hello, Bowser. I like that he points out if it keeps going at this rate, Koopa Kid will win. We can't have that. He's your son. Why are you being so harsh on him?
Bowser is an abusive parent.
And apparently now all coin spaces are tripled. Get ready for some mad dosh.
That no one will get to use.
And it's time for a duel! Oh, hello!
Duel!
Boo is being clever here, betting 50 coins against the store. This though, holy crap. The most dangerous game.
Very poppy. Finish!
Oh, wow, Boo.
Yeah. So, this is basically mad button mashing?
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, damn it, Boo.
You could have had it all.
One balloon.
Instead
and,
he fell.
Yeah, and Boo can actually float, so why even bother?
Instead he fell into the crafty well of Jupiter.
It ain't easy.
A ghost floating on balloons, that's pathetic.
Well, that was a bit of a downer, wasn't it? Had he won, he would have evened it out and reached first place. But as it is now, he's probably stuck in second for a while. Meanwhile, Koopa Kid just keeps getting more and more coins and pulling ahead. Oh hey, someone is placing a chance space. Let's see if anyone actually ends up on it.
Yeah. All stars to Boo! All stars to Boo!
Seems like a bouncer space is coming up.
Yep.
It is time.
Yes!
Bouncer Revolution! Holy crap! Well, Waluigi! Seems that the only thing you had going for you is now forfeit. Oh, Waluigi, you poor bastard.
It doesn't redistribute stars anymore.
No. They probably figured that that was a smidge too harsh.
Mario Party is all about harshness.
Looks like Bowser was his revolutionary edge.
Maybe they should replace.
Oh shit. Someone's coming up on the star and getting extra dosh. If he grabs that star, he has a chance to hit second. Let's see how the minigame ends up. It's another free coin minigame. I like that the minigame essentially comes down to someone stand where the coins will land while the other person jumps. And the AI manages to turn it into how many coins can we drop off the side. Finish! I am not impressed.
Well, the AI in this game is pretty impressive, but for all the wrong reasons.
I suppose. The question is, Boo, can you roll high enough to catch up and pass him? No. Not really. So close, yet so far away. All he needed was a roll of, what is it, 4 or 5? It was definitely within striking range. It looks like it's time to go again. time for a duel.
On about the space.
Yep. So no matter what happens in the duel, I think we got another surprise coming immediately afterwards. Looking forward to it.
Bowser just comes along and says, "You won! Congratulations! Now give me all your money!"
This mini game again.
This game is kind of lame.
Hey, this is all skill, baby. Man, look at all them greens. Man, look at all those points. Badass green combo settles it for Kid Cooper. And yes, I know that I'm alternating between Cooper Kid and Kid Cooper back and forth, but hey, that's just the sort of man I am.
I bet not even Nintendo can actually keep it consistent.
Right, so about those coin you just won, Cooper Kid?
Well, they're mine.
It's Bowser time.
Your asshole dad is coming over to take them all.
Oh my god, again? Welp.
Bowser is all about the 99%.
See guys, this is why you shouldn't duel over coins, because Bowser will come along and just even things out and teach you the importance of not being stuck, I guess.
Bowser's here to teach you about the great advantages of socialism.
And then Waluigi immediately steals Koopa Kid's money. He learned nothing. Come on, roll a one, you fat bastard. Roll a one. You can do it. No. I guess it was too much to ask. But the next star is ahead. It will come down to who can roll the dice the best. And oh no, Wario will be slowed on the next turn due to a cursed mushroom. Which might give Boo the extra space he needs to actually pull ahead.
Unless he lands on it as well.
I suppose. Let's not even bring that possibility up. Also, we all know it's probably going to happen.
And this again.
Yeah, well,
yay.
You need to relax a bit between all these high tempo minigames, yes.
It's just like last time.
It seems that Team 2 is slightly ahead. Question is, can they keep it up? Waboo!
I like to think that the cheap sub, surprise expression is like sheer horror from, "Oh god, there are people inside me!"
I never asked to be turned into a submarine.
I never asked for this.
I never asked for fish. Oh, sorry.
It's amazing how Nintendo predicted the new Deus Ex game.
9 years ahead of time, man. Those guys.
And now they're getting the exclusive director's cut version, which will apparently fix the boss fight. Wii U exclusive.
Is that a Bubba Boo? The truth? No, the
oh,
flame Bob guy.
Boo, no. The storm. The one space you should not have landed on. You unfortunate little ghost. And he has to pay for it too, just to add insult to injury.
If you want to save your friend, solve my maze, boo. And pay me.
Here we go. Capsule rearrangement with two playable turns left. It's going to change the game, bro. Changes everything. Well, I suppose that all we Team Boo can hope for now is that Wario gets the star and the next star turns out to be right ahead of Boo so he can grab it on the last turn. Either that or some hidden star spaces, that would be great too. Go for it.
Weren't we cursing this bullshit last game?
Yeah, what kind of, like, what could the freaking Wii U add to Deus Ex Human Revolution? I don't get it.
And the inventory screen on the pad, I suppose.
Other than that, I don't see exactly what.
And worse graphics than the PC version, maybe?
Well, they keep saying that, oh, well, this is going to be like Wii U exclusive, we're not going to patch the other versions, I just hope that they're lying. It wouldn't make any sense.
Oh my god, Wario, why now? Why now of all times be so slow? You dick.
Wario hates us.
It's time for some bombardment. Boo wins by doing nothing. That right there.
Mario Party in a nutshell. Wow! Kid Koopa and Luigi just literally blew themselves up.
Yep. Mutually assured destruction.
It's probably thinking, we can't kill the ghost, well, might as well end it.
We have a slight problem in regards to this, you see, because our opponent is a ghost, and thus already dead. We have looked into various possibilities, but realized that it just won't work. And let's see where this ends up bringing our dear Kid Koopa. Two steps away from the star, he decides to just get some extra money. Man, this is an attraction I wouldn't mind riding in real life.
It's a bit slow though, isn't it?
Yeah.
But that just makes it easier to get the money.
Well, in terms of it, well, I think it actually reminds me of one of the ones in Disneyland, but I can't remember which. Yeah, it was probably Dumbo, the Valley Stairs.
Determine the amount of coins you will lose. And he has nixed them. Seriously, Waluigi...
Screw you!
Why do you have to be like this? Some coins have been taken, you don't say, asshole. Waluigi's really betting everything on that coin star, isn't he?
Wario.
Star for you.
No, Wario.
Oh, Wario, why are you such terrible? Ow, 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 ow.
Oh my god, look out, it's an army of missing numbers.
Was that a From Mission reference?
No, it's a Pokemon reference.
We're being attacked by missing no.
Oh.
It's the last turn. Why would you not use the mushroom on yourself, Bo? Like, seriously.
Moron party.
I suppose since he already landed on a mushroom space, so it probably doesn't actually take any effect, but... Let's see, will this actually be enough to reach the star? You never know. Run, Bo, run! No, he's on the wrong platform. He will get halfway across the map, though. He should get a bonus star just for being such a good runner.
Well, Boo can run as fast as death.
But he doesn't have legs.
He arrives at the speed of darkness.
Which is several times faster than the speed of light.
See, Wario, just because you had to be a moron, Kid Koopa's probably won this one. And the next star is off in the distance where no one will reach it.
God, look at his face. He's that smug as hell face.
Smuggo. And now Waluigi's going to slowly but surely ride around in a circle while we wait, despite the fact that there's no use in the game even continuing, most likely. The only chance right now is that Boo get both the happening star and the minigame star. In that case, he will be able to pull off a win. But otherwise, it's in Kid Koopa's hands. So we deliver ourselves to you, O Lord, and pray that Boo has what it takes. Now someone is setting fire to their microphone.
I think it's overflight.
Sorry?
Yeah, we were just curious why you were setting fire to your microphone, but...
Oh, sorry about that. I dropped it.
Right, this is the end. Let's see. The final minigame. And it's a battle minigame. Holy shit, is this where it changed? Whoa. Here we go.
All starts to Kid Koopa.
This right here. If Kid Koopa wins this one, then he's guaranteed a victory. But he's the first one off, that's perfect. Come on, Boo, if you can pull this one off. But he doesn't.
Come on, Wario.
No, Wario!
But you do realize that by Wario winning, he has ruined everything.
I don't care about Boo.
You want Kid Koopa to win.
Well, no, but...
Man, those coins just keep going. Jeez.
God damn it, Boo.
Get damn. Very nice. Let's see how nice. Super nice. Double nice. Minigame star goes to...
Well, Luigi...
Wario!
This looks weird. I'm floating.
As if Wario pulls off a sudden win from behind.
Wario seems pretty excited about this, this
featuring story. Kid Koopa.
Yeah.
No. No.
Wario's loving the hell out of this shit.
But Waluigi seems a bit confused about the void.
Yeah.
Not really digging it.
You are the dream star. And wow, they didn't really let us watch the stats there, did you? That was rigged to the shit and back. Screw you, Bowser.
This game is... yeah.
Fuck this noise. Alright,
as... you, Kid Koopa.
As usual, there will be a reset period of a minute or two while we tally scores and so on. But hang in there, there will be another round in just a bit. Make sure to scream a lot and share in the stream chat if you manage to place a correct bet so I can note you down, by the way. Freaking Koopa Kid, goddamn.
Did anyone actually vote for Koopa?